Hi friends, again we are back. So in the first part we dealt up to the ninth paragraph. Now let's begin with the tenth paragraph. So till now we have seen that Okenatu, he was finding it difficult to work in the bank as he was not getting the proper payment. In the meanwhile, Sitaram came for his help. So he informed the woman, Mrs. Prakash, about Natu, and Mrs. Prakash was really in search of someone to get her hot air cleaned. So she asked Sitaram to inform Natu to come and meet her. So till there we have seen. Now let's move ahead. Soon after, Mrs. Prakash set out for the bazaar to make her usual afternoon tour of the cloth shops. So, after listening to Sidharam and informing him all about, Mrs. Prakash went towards the bazaar. She used to go to the bazaar in order to check the new arrivals of the clothes shops in the bazaar. So she was on her daily routine or usual routine. A large shady tamarind tree grew near the clock tower. It was here that she found her friend Mrs. Bhushan sheltering from the heat. So actually all the story was happening during the summer season. So Mrs. Prakash, as she was on her way towards the bazaar, she came nearby the clock tower or the tamarind tree. So under the shade of the tamarind tree, Mrs. Bhushan was having some rest from the heat of the sun. So Mrs. Prakash met Mrs. Bhushan under the tamarind tree. "Do you know, my dear," Mrs. Prakash said, "that Seth Govindram's bank can't even pay its employees?" So on meeting Mrs. Bhushan, Mrs. Prakash asked whether she came to know about Seth Govindram's bank, that it wasn't able to pay its employees. So the very moment she met Mrs. Bhushan, Mrs. Prakash asked this question. "Only this morning I heard a complaint from their sweeper boy who hasn't received his pay for 2 months. So she informed Mrs. Bhushan that only that morning that she got the information from the sweeper boy that he hadn't received the salary of 2 months from the bank. "It's disgraceful," exclaimed Mrs. Bhushan. "If they can't pay the sweeper boy, they must be in a bad way." So Mrs. Bhushan said that it was quite unbecoming that a bank didn't pay its salary to the sweeper boy. So she further said that, okay, all right, that if a bank couldn't pay the sweeper boy his salary, that meant that the bank was on the verge of ruin or was going through a bad situation or was in loss. None of the others can be getting paid either. So Mrs. Bhushan also further guessed that other employees might also not be getting the salary. Mrs. Bhushan left Mrs. Prakash at the tamarind tree and went in search of her husband, who was found sitting under the fan in Jugal Kishore's electrical goods shop, talking with the owner. So in the meanwhile, Mrs. Bhushan, she was really in search of her husband. So she was on her way To find out her husband, in the meanwhile, she took rest under the tamarind tree. So she further continued. So she left Prakash under the tree and she moved ahead in search of her husband. And as she went further, she could meet her husband sitting in an electrical shop. So the shop was owned by Jugal Kishore. Mrs. Bhushan's husband was talking to the owner of the electrical shop, Jugal Kishore. "So there you are," cried Mrs. Bhushan. "I have been looking for you for nearly an hour. I don't know what's happening to this town. Do you know the bank is going bankrupt?" So, on meeting her husband, Mrs. Bhushan said that she was really in search of him for an hour, and she further informed her husband that the bank was about to be bankrupt, or the bank was really in loss, or the bank was getting collapsed. "What did you say?" said Mr. Jugal Kishore, sitting up suddenly. "Which bank?" So in the meanwhile, okay, on hearing the information from her, Jugal Kishore all of a sudden asked Mrs. Bhushan what she said, and he further asked her which bank that she meant. "Why," said Govindram's bank, "of course. I hear they have stopped paying their employees no salary for over 3 months. Don't tell me you have an account with them, Mr. Kishore." "So, okay, all right." So she further informed, when Jugal Kishore asked which bank she meant, she said that it was Seth Govindram's bank. And that, okay, all right, she informed Jugal Kishore that the bank had stopped paying the salary to its employees for 3 months. See, here we mean exactly how rumor is spread out and how the rumors are quiet away from the reality. See, when Sitaram informed Mrs. Prakash it was of the pending salary was of 2 months. Now when Mrs. Bhushan informed Jugal Kishore, it became of 3 months. See, rumor is quite different from the reality. So let us get ahead. "No, but my neighbor has," he said, and he called out to the keeper of the barber shop next door. "Faizhuzain, have you heard the latest?" said Govindram's bank is about to collapse. So when Jugal Kishore heard all about the news of the bank, all of a sudden he was quiet. Shocked. So in the meanwhile, Mrs. Bhushan asked whether he had any account in the bank. So as a reply to her, Jugal Kishore informed that he didn't have, but his neighbor had the account. So in the meanwhile, Jugal Kishore called out to the nearby shop. It was a barber shop. So he called out to the owner Faiz Hussain and asked whether he knew the latest news of the bank. Then in the meanwhile, he informed Faiz Hussain that Seth Govindram's bank was about to collapse or about to come to an end. Faiz Hussain, who was cutting the hair of an elderly gentleman, was so startled that his hand shook and he nicked his customer's right ear. The customer yelped with pain and distress, pain because of the cut and distress because of the awful news he had just heard. So in the meanwhile, Faiz Hussain was busy with his work cutting the hair of an elderly elder man. And while he heard the news, he was quite shocked and he lost his concentration. As a result, he slightly cut the right ear of the customer. So the customer cried with pain and distress. Cried with pain and unhappiness because. Okay, all right. So now let us see what are the two reasons for his The customer yelped with pain and distress, pain because of the cut and distress because of the awful news he had just heard. See, customer really cried just because of the reason that, okay, all right. For two reasons he cried. First of all, his right ear was cut by the barber Faiz Hussain. Second reason was that he could not believe the latest news that he overheard of the bank. So that was also a shocking news for the customer. With one side of his neck still unshorn, he leapt out of his chair. He leaped out of his chair and sped across the road to a general store where there was a telephone. So okay, all right, only the right side was getting cut. The other side, right side and the back side, was yet to be cut. The hair was yet to be cut. So in the meanwhile, okay, all right, all of a sudden the customer came out of the chair and he ran towards the general store where there was the common telephone. So he moved towards, he dialed Seth Govind Ram's number. So he was the customer who was getting or who was receiving the haircut ran towards the general store in search of the telephone in order to dial the number of Seth Govind Ram's. Okay, fine. So let's go for a short break and we will come back after some time. So in the meanwhile, you may please read through the chapter.